his mouth, you see a black void. Alidir shoots arrows into the door to the face of flesh. As the face flesh rips off the door and leaves a black hole in it, there are two statues on the other side, which is actually four, so on and so forth. There are inscriptions on each of them of the base of the statues there in Arcana. Read it. An aura of protection that prevents something from being damaged is what describes it, and there is some magic coming from it. Their faces look like flesh golems. There's a stone pedestal with a knight's helmet on it. A winged design on the sides, like from Skyrim. There's corruption magic on the helmet. The helmet is black and matches the magic of the black bracelet. There is summoning magic on the pedestal. Four statues all in the same each corner. There's a door in the back of the room with cave paintings that say underground passengers used to escape the city in a time of peril. We pour some of the brown liquid on stuff and nothing happens. Pour more liquid on a lot of stuff and nothing happens. Sure. Anyways, we tie rope to the helmet and head for the tapestry door. We try to push on the door, but it doesn't open. The black helmet has no effect on the door. There's a helmet involved in the tapestry. We can't open the door, and we pull the helmet off the pedestal, and four eyes appear out of midair. Davros puts the helmet on and tries to open the door. He pushes the door open. The beast has hooves and wings and begins to follow us. The helmet does not come off Davros. We begin to run down the hallway, and it spreads into different tunnels and widen out and around 20 feet high. Harbeck knows that this is a champion of some evil god. The tunnel is narrow, and there's a light at the end of the tunnel. Rana and Aladir get caught by the beast. Aladir pushes Rana ahead, and Hrothgar carries Rana out of the tunnel. Aladir fires away and runs for the tunnel exit. He hits it in the eyes, and it howls in pain. We manage to get away, and we are in a mountain range. Below there is a forest. We follow that path downwards. The champion can't chase us when it sees the sun and stops at the edge of the cave. It will be dark in an hour. Make it to the forest.
Butts.
Alright.
Did I hear a mention of Skyrim in your recap?
Yes.
The helmet kind of looked like one from Skyrim-ish with the wings on the side, but it didn't have the visor.
Do we know what Skyrim is? Is it a land that's adjacent?
Oh, you know.
No, I mean,
is there your rim somewhere in the sky?
It's like a rim job, only, you know.
Wow. How would a helmet look like that?
Hot air balloon. Anyways. So, guys, that was shit scary. Anyone else going to change their undergarments?
I'm all
right. Okay.
Where are those?
So, wait, we're outside of the forest, right?
Yeah. Mountains above you, the forest is below you.
Vincent, you're not actually in the game, by the way.
I realize that now.
You're in the... There's an, like a new one, Real Terror 3.
Makes sense. And
since we're on Act 3...
Hey guys. So it really seemed like the champion could not be present in the sunlight. It will be dark soon, so what's our plan?
I don't know. There's a big forest in front of us. I think we just finished off last time, not realizing that we couldn't see anything or anywhere to go, basically, right? It's just a bunch
good.
Of mountain walls and
well,
shit.
It destroyed the sun. You can roll a perception check if you want.
Didn't we already do that?
I don't think so.
No?
I don't know.
What are we perceiving exactly? The horizon?
What's all this weather shit in the chat?
I guess what do you guys want to look for?
If there's any endpoint to the
forest... I already
forest,
said I
they...
wanted to look for a village or something, yeah.
Oh, well, there's none in sight, but yeah.
Oh, okay. What are you looking for, Josh?
If there's any paths or direct markings.
Roads?
Yeah, like something that looks like it would lead to a way out.
Sure, roll a perception check.
That's probably good enough that I'm not going to bother rolling.
Yeah, you see a road off to the south. You can't see which direction it really leads to, but it's basically through south. Through the forest, and there's kind of a road on the other side.
Okay.
Where is...
So, what part of the forest are we on? The north? Like, are we on the opposite
yeah.
end of where this path is?
Yeah, so... Road. And then... Forest. There you go. That's basically what your landscape looks like.
Uh, Okay. So, I mean...
What's through here? Is there actually a gap here?
Yeah, it's just open plains.
So we could go around the forest and get to the road as well? Can we see that?
Yeah.
Oh.
We should stay on the edge of the forest.
Why are you... What is that?
It's a tree.
Why is it red?
Burgundy.
Blood trees?
Isn't that brown? Oh, no.
No, it's definitely red.
Oh, crap, it is red.
So,
I mean, you might be colorblind.
Daggerfall being over here, is there, like, is that the outer walls of Daggerfall?
Yeah.
And we can tell that? No. Jesus Christ, calm down, whoever's trying to be artistic.
Fix it.
Okay. Wow. Fucking erase a chunk of that forest.
Yeah, I agree with the original point that we should stay on the outskirts of the forest, just that we have easy traversing and a quick place to hide. If
well, now the plains say hills. Does that mean it's going to take us longer to go over the plains?
No, I mean, there's hills there and plains.
How far about is the road from where we are?
It will take you about... 3 hours.
3 hours?
Yeah.
And what time is it currently?
I think I said 6 last time.
So, guys, here's the problem. If we go on the plains and the hills, we don't have any cover. And if it's 6 right now, I'm assuming you mean PM, right?
Yes.
And we don't get to the road till 3, that's nighttime again. Now, we can assume that the thing isn't going to leave the cave and come after us. But if it does, I'm assuming we're going to light torches so we don't trip and break our legs and ankles, and it will see that. Even if we don't light torches, I don't know if it has night vision. So, while I agree that the forest is much less safe and will take longer than the plains, we have to consider the fact that we're wide open if we go on the plains.
Well, yeah, that's what we were saying, that we could go on the outskirts when you didn't hear anything of that.
No,
yeah,
I know. So you're assuming that as soon as we, like, if we hear or see something,
we duck into the forest? Yes.
All right. Sure.
Maybe we can just move over to the forest. Like, just try and get as much ground as we can on the, like, plains and then move into the forest when it starts to get dark.
Fair enough. The forest looks accessible from the sides, Dallas. Like it's.
I mean, it's only like one giant tree. So.
Yeah, the forest is one giant tree. You're either in the tree or.
Okay, as long as the forest is accessible from the sides, then sure.
Yeah, I mean, there's nothing really stopping.
No, there's just a giant.
I didn't know if there was a dense thicket of bushes or something.
There's just a wall of trees just blocking your path all the way along one side.
This is a solid wood wall.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So yeah, you guys just. How much does everyone have their rations marked down?
No.
Okay, then I guess you guys have the standard adventures kit.
Yeah, we had the standard adventure kits.
Okay, I'm assuming we refilled in Daggerfall.
Well, I mean that actually costs money, but I mean I remember that Aladir got some rations.
What's his name?
He got bread, didn't he?
What's his name again? The dude who like tried to fuck us over and had the opium and shit. We were in his carriage. Aloe, didn't he give a shit?
He gave you shit while you were traveling with him.
I thought he gave a shit when we got back to the city.
He gave us a lot of shit over it.
I don't think
we specifically asked for rations.
No, you guys got money from him.
Extra rations?
The standard adventures kit comes with 10 days. Aladir, I think you forged some in the forest one day randomly. You got, like, I think it was a few.
If you really want us to, we'll eat Harbeck.
Okay.
No one laughed.
I mean, he consented.
Why would you laugh at that?
That is...
I don't need both my legs.
Yes, you do. You'll definitely be encumbered if you don't have both your legs.
No, I can't be encumbered. I'm so fine with me.
Okay, so basically you forged enough food for a day.
Okay.
Yeah, for everyone. So basically you all have 11 days worth of rations. Mark that down.
11 days worth of rations.
Each of you, yes. Yep, because you guys didn't use any of your rations yet. That was all been paid for by Aelum, and you were in the city, so, I mean, yeah.
Yeah, you just assumed we went to bars every night.
Yeah.
And every day.
Well, inns, probably.
We also
I don't know. Well, you guys probably are drinking booze every night. It's probably with cleaner than water, so yeah.
Can you put my character on the screen so I can use the thing that is a counter, so I can use that for rations?
Oh,
Is there like a place for rations on
thanks.
This like sheet?
I just did it in my dock for my inventory.
Yeah, you just do it
I
in
just
your
added in something called rations, and the description is 11 days.
But if you go to, I can't actually click on my character because he's not on the screen right
there
now.
There isn't. That's all the student thing.
If you do it on your character, you could just make it one of the bars, probably.
That's what I'm doing.
Yeah, that's what I was going to do. But we need our characters to be in the game.
Yeah, I mean, this is basically a crude map, so I'm not going to put everyone's characters on. You might as well just mark it down in your docs.
Losers. I'm the only one who got it.
Or destroy them. Well. Yeah. Just delete them. Delete them. You have to do it.
No.
It's only fair.
I'm already there. It's...
Fuck it.
Whoa!
Get fucked.
Yeah, bitches.
Okay, so... Yeah, 3 hours goes by. You guys just... You're walking along the road. Or you're walking along the side of the forest, and you guys eventually
nothing
hit the road.
Nothing happens in the 3 hours?
No, nothing.
We don't hear anything? No screeching?
No, it's right at the 3 hour mark that everything happens.
No, nothing happens.
Okay.
You guys don't hear a thing. So you guys are at the road. What do you guys do?
Well... So what, are we gonna continue researching Red Eye and stuff, guys? Because
I think the more pressing matter is that giant beast.
No, I know, but I'm trying
lady.
To figure out what way we go.
With Ghost Lady, you know.
Oh yeah.
I think we need to get more information out of.
Yeah, where does she want us to go?
Hold on.
Well, I thought she was just helping us get out of the city.
She kind of just goes with us and doesn't say anything ever unless we ask her.
Yeah, she's kind of like a mute.
Yeah,
like a
sorry about that.
She's really just on the hunt.
I mean, during those 3 hours, does anyone do anything?
Fuck it, let's eat her instead.
Yeah, let's just do that.
Oh my.
She showed us the way out of the city, that's all we want.
We'll make some light conversation.
I mean, during the 3 hours, I would assume we'd have this discussion.
Yeah.
So, obviously we know that looking at this map, to the west is Daggerfall, which is where we came from. To the east is unknown stuff. So the leads we have, I'm assuming we're not going to go back to fucking Daggerfall. So, the leads we have to go off are, man, I'm going to forget her name. I can't remember her name.
Ithania.
There's Ithania's shit. I don't know what I don't remember what she wanted to do after we got out of the city. There's Red Eye, and then there's the whole like dragonborn eggs pilfering stuff at that castle that I can't remember the name of. I'm gonna go look.
I think
back.
We're past. I don't know if we're even gonna be doing that.
No. Da-da-da-da-da. Understone Keep. I don't remember which direction it was.
Because that was a quest for the evil guy. The evil...
Well, I mean, kind of. I thought we were still... I mean, up until Ithania existed, we were going to pursue that anyway.
Up until we realized that he was a bad guy.
I guess. To... So we're just going to let the Draconians get fucked?
What do you mean?
Well, they're still stealing all the dragon eggs and shit. There's still stuff to possibly do there. Are we not a roving band of mercenaries?
We're not going to get paid.
You don't know that?
Who would pay us?
Yeah, exactly.
I don't know. The fucking Draconians who we save stuff from?
You don't know that.
We don't know. Okay, well, then what do we do? Somebody else fucking give me an idea.
My main concern is get away from Demon, get away from Super Death City where everyone wants us dead, and just go somewhere else.
Well, I mean, during this time, if any, I guess, strikes up conversations with you guys and says, I mean, you guys, now that you guys are free, along with you, what are your goals at this point?
Is it just like, me, or are you cutting out a lot?
Yeah,
I don't understand the simple
like,
thing.
I am. Oh. Hold on.
It was better there where you said, oh, hold on.
Okay. Well, anyways, please, she starts asking you guys, like, what are your goals, basically? Why, what are your goals from here on out?
I mean, what are your goals? I'm still very unclear as to why she's with us.
I was thinking at this point I'd just go on my way.
Where are you going?
Wherever I please. Away from here, obviously, but I mean, what purpose do you have to continue on with me?
Feel like you owe us an explanation?
Kind of, maybe, yeah.
I would also like to know why we just did a bunch of things.
Like, you kind of helped us out of the city, but we also kind of got into a bunch of shit because of Rayon's crazy wet dream visions.
We wouldn't have, like, been in as much trouble in the first place.
We would have been almost zero trouble, really.
Yeah.
If you think about it.
Okay. Rayon, what do you have to say? Dibba?
Sorry, I was just trying to look through notes for something. I want to go back to the fact that as part of the deal for me releasing you, the other part of the deal on your end was supposed to heal my father.
Yes, I said my mistress would probably have the cure.
Do we know about this? I feel like we don't know about this.
No, I explained everything.
Did you explain it to Dapros? I thought you did.
No, he just explained it to Trine.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's also confusing because, you know, in the recaps I explain it, and then, you know, I don't know if I do it in character or not.
I don't remember hearing it in the recaps, though.
I don't remember hearing anything about this.
Okay, so the whole thing was I was supposed to free her, and she would her mistress would heal my father.
And this was agreed upon when? Like, while you were still having the dreams?
No, she was came to me in the dream, told me that.
The first one?
Yeah, so before we even went to the house, this was a deal that was set up.
It wasn't a deal. She said that if you did this, then this would happen. And it just so happened that that house was marked on the map that we were going to anyways.
Okay. I feel like we've been used.
How so? I am also feeling similar feelings.
How so?
Because you didn't tell us this, and we just went to this house and murdered all these people so that you could heal your father without telling us that there was any purpose behind it for that?
Okay, on the one hand, I actually thought I did. Secondly,
yeah, I was gonna say he thought he did.
Secondly, it was on the map. That was a predestined location determined by the map that we found. That we would have gone there regardless. It was sheer coincidence that we ended up there.
I think that's fine and all, but is she going to...
She's just, like, leaving us now, though.
Yeah.
Obviously, she still has business with you.
Yeah, and so that's why I'm not accepting the fact that she can just leave and expect
me
to go find her.
Yeah, I know, right now. The fact that she's just, like, ditching us.
Like, I would like my end of the bargain to be dealt with, and you're my only, like, assurance to the fact that it will happen. So I don't think you can just leave the party until this is, you know, dealt with.
Right, but in order to get the cure, I'd have to get to my mistress.
Right, where the fuck are you planning on going on your own?
Are we not allowed to go?
I know, but I mean, at this point, what about the... Why would anyone else... I mean, like, do you have any other goals in any of this?
We can't stay in Daggerfall. We need another place to go.
Okay.
Our only other issue is that we've... possibly released a hellbent champion of some demon god to slaughter everyone. That being said, we have no resources whatsoever in terms of being able to find out how to defeat it, how to stop it, whether or not it is. Yeah. So, at the very least, do we have any knowledge or anybody we know that we could possibly go to solve this?
Quite possibly. But at the same time, so you guys are basically all just doing this for a reward? You all
I was going to say, who's paying us for this? Are we just doing this out of the goodness of our hearts?
Doing this for no reason?
I'm fucking not. You guys just said that we wouldn't go save the Draconians because we wouldn't get paid.
I agree. I want to get paid for this as well.
Yeah.
I'm literally a mercenary.
So, are you paying us, Rayon, or is she paying us?
Okay, that's all well and fair. That's all well and fair. Right? But we also may have doomed the entire planet.
It's not my concern until it actually happens.
I don't think he's actually going to kill like everybody else.
He might just kill us. Yeah, I think there's quite a lot of
the fact that,
people.
Davros still has the helmet, he might be the one being chased. We might be targets for the entire time that we travel.
Okay, bye, Davros.
Thanks, Ray.
No. Maybe.
The interest of our party would be to solve this issue.
The helmet and your father are completely separate issues.
I think it's fine to get information first. If you want payment, I think you could possibly use the fact that we know how to get rid of it as blackmail.
I'm fine investigating about the helmet and stuff, because I'm sure the helmet is probably worth something in and of its own. But this is all pure speculation. We don't know if the thing can even leave the cave.
You're right, we don't. So let's do some research first and figure things out.
Okay.
And in the meantime, Ithania, I don't think you can leave. I don't think your debt is paid, and I don't think it can be paid until we settle this. And you're the only insurance that we have.
No debt whatsoever.
No debt to me.
She just fucked us and left.
No, she has a debt to me.
No, that's what I'm saying.
He's saying nothing has been paid yet. At all.
Exactly. Like, and so as an insurance policy, I can't let her leave the party.
Okay. I mean, how are you going to enforce that? I'm not speaking for Ithania. I'm just musing out loud at this point. What is she doing?
Well, she has something to do, but...
Dallas.
I mean...
Sorry, were you asking that directly to me?
No, I was saying maybe you should fucking act for her. She's not just going to sit here through all this.
You're kind of trying to speak and argue with an invisible person.
I don't know if you guys are speculating out of character. Okay.
Yeah, I mean, you guys do speak.
We're kind of accusing her of, like, completely fucking our whole party, basically.
I mean, yeah.
Why would you guys, What was your quest to begin with, anyways, before you met me?
Make money.
Investigating Red Eye.
So you want Red Eye? For what reason?
I mean, we don't necessarily want him, but he was wanted. He has a high bounty.
And so you want him for his bounty?
Yeah.
Basically. Plan.
Okay. Because I know what he's after.
Do you? And you didn't tell us.
And you didn't tell us this until
why?
Now?
Because I didn't know your motives?
I mean,
no one explained this.
That's fair. Tell us.
Okay. Well, he was after me because, well, he knows where my mistress is.
Did we not fucking ask her? I'm sorry to interrupt you. Did we not ask her if she knew something about Red Eye or if he was after her or anything like this? I feel like we fucking did.
Yeah, but she didn't know your motives behind it.
Oh, God.
She's really making us not trust her at all.
Anyways, I know he is after my mistress, and he was trying to use me to get to her.
Okay.
Why is he after your mistress again? Just for power?
You're going to have to explain a lot of stuff here. How did he capture you? Blah, blah, blah. Why were you in that house? Do you know any of these things? He's after your mistress for powers?
Yes, she has a lot of power. And she... And he wants to use that power for... I'm assuming to summon more of these demons. Because that demon was a champion of a god called, I believe you people in the common tongue call him Nightmare.
Okay.
Would your mistress potentially help us in this, or even reward us?
Award you? Yes, she has a lot of items that she could spare. I believe the item he was after was a Ring of Wishes.
Okay.
Then do you have any idea what this helmet I'm wearing is?
No. I'm afraid I don't.
Is there any secret to beating this demon?
Beating this demon, agents of Nightmare tend to be weak against light. However, if he gets too big of a grasp on this world, he will,
roam without fear.
So is he going to be chasing after us?
Well, he'll be chasing after me.
Okay, and you were going to go off by yourself?
Yes.
You thought that was a good idea?
Yes.
Oh! Okay! And how did you come to that conclusion? You're just going to fight it by yourself?
Well, I just go to the next town, hire some more people, and then be on my way.
Okay. So you would I don't even understand. She's, like, fucking so dumb. This is a thought. I'm not saying that out loud.
Okay.
I'm sorry, but she's... Oh, God. Okay.
So the person to deal with our troubles is your mistress.
Yes.
Why don't we travel with you to your mistress, then?
Well, that's why I was asking what your motives were to continue on with me.
I mean, after all that, did you really think we wanted to take advantage of anything?
Yeah, now we're gonna go sell you on the black market. Whoops, sorry, I guess we just fought through all those guards and saved your life so we could go screw you over.
Well, people are greedy.
But I mean...
You contacted us through magical dreams.
Why did you contact us? Yeah, that's a good question. If you don't know our motives and you don't trust us, why did you contact us?
I needed to get out, I was captured.
But why us?
First people I managed to get a hold of.
Yeah, she explained this one before.
Why wouldn't it be... I know, but I mean, why were we the first ones you managed to get a hold of?
Oh my god.
She said this just happens tense.
What the fuck?
Yeah, she said this before.
I'm just trying to understand this magic, because we were...
But she said this before. She is just the first, like suitable candidate.
No, I know. I just find it weird, because we were, like, nowhere near her.
We were in the same
dream
city.
Yeah.
I know.
The dream realm is spontaneous. I can't control it.
Okay, whatever.
Only my mistress can.
So where does your mistress live again? Somewhere really far away?
Ice Crown.
I remember it was like north
so
or
how
something.
Far away is Ice Crown from Daggerfall?
Daggerfall, you guys are in Irelia. That's like, what, 2 countries away? So about, what, Jesus. 6 months?
Great.
So
do we really want to do this?
Is there any faster way to get there?
Possibly. There's a way in Norrath.
Where's Norrath?
That's 1 country up, so that's 3 months.
Oh, God.
Well, either way, you guys are in the middle of nowhere. It took you guys how long to get from the original city? 2 weeks?
So
that was like half a month, yeah.
Wait a second. She came all the way to Daggerfall to see Forwyn, right?
No, I was captured in Norrath and brought here.
What? Oh.
Captured? So you were captured? Did you know who captured you at the time?
I would assume it was Red Eye. I was running from him beforehand.
Oh, he's been chasing you for a while then?
I think we would have to assume Red Eye has influence with... What's his bucket? The Count. Baron guy.
Baron something.
Of the Lord Daggerfall or whatever?
Lord Bannon.
Okay. He's been chasing you for a while.
I remember when we first asked the guards, they said that Red Eye had potentially corrupted the city from within.
Yeah.
I guess that's where it started.
And that's why they said that Lord Bannon was a man of power.
We were looking for Fulwyn so that he could help us get out of the city?
We were looking for Fulwyn because Athenia knew him.
Okay. Do we just not give a shit about him now?
We don't even know where he is.
I guess. Probably.
Like, we were looking for him because he was arrested, and we were wondering why.
Well, whatever, wherever he is, I don't think he's that significant anymore, frankly.
Okay, so our options are going all the way to Ice Crown to possibly get some reward that may or may not be worth it. 6 months. Possibly
or three
months.
Months.
Or looking for something else that's more of in our general area.
But
and
we'd have to
not
go back to
risking
Daggerfall.
Our lives being chased by a demon champion and a crazy evil man.
But we'd have to go back to Daggerfall. Are we even welcome back there?
Why would we have to go back to Daggerfall? Why can't we just go somewhere else?
How would we investigate anything related to this outside of Daggerfall? Isn't it all in Daggerfall?
I'm not saying we investigate stuff. I'm just saying we go fuck off and do something else.
So you're gonna disregard all the work that Dell has put into this entire story and choose to do something entirely random.
It's fine.
I'm
being in my character and trying to be rational in my character.
I'm doing the same thing right now in my head.
I'm acting as my character would, and my character does not see the value in traveling 3 to 6 months to. Like, if she promised us amazing rewards, maybe my greed would overcome that. But 6 months, perilous danger, all this stuff. Wishes. What?
A ring of wishes.
Ring of wishes, but we don't even know if she has... Okay, so Red Eye is trying to get this ring. Obviously, yes. It's pretty valuable. Us yes. stopping him from getting the ring is enough for us to get the ring ourselves?
Yes.
Did Ithania directly promise that?
Well, if you want the ring, I could have that arranged.
Because all I've heard from her is gifts, so unless there's, like, specifics, it's kind of hard to go off of. We could all get complimentary chocolates, for all I know.
Why are you fine with us having the ring?
Yeah,
you don't know us.
At that point, yeah.
That's what I'm saying, this woman is crazy. I think she's just insane.
Yeah, my mistress wills it, then you will have it. That's why, if you put all that effort in, then you guys would be worth giving the ring to.
But we don't know that. Like, we could go there, and she could just be like, oh, hey, thanks. Cool.
Yeah, okay, but the fact that we risk our lives...
But, I mean, anyone can do that. Anyone can cheat you out of a payment like that. Not just me.
Oh, yeah, I know, but we don't have to travel 6 months.
Well, we don't know. You don't know how many months you have to travel to get to the next town. That
would
be
it's at least
after
three.
You.
Unless somebody summons some sort of magical teleportation whirlwind.
Like that cloud pathway that we did in the mountain.
Yeah, that's
are there no portals between cities?
No, I don't. No, magical portals aren't really a thing. I mean, if you find a magical portal, that's pretty damn rare.
Okay.
Roll perception check.
One appears in the forest.
Right next to you.
Kidding. Fuck. Okay. Honestly?
I mean, I would say take a vote, but I feel like I know what the general consensus leans already. Maybe I'm reading it wrong.
I mean, if you guys want to go off and do something else, that's fine. I actually do have other stuff, so...
I don't see the time invested being worth it, and that's just from my perspective.
I agree.
The demon something intrigues me.
The demon intrigues me, but also it doesn't intrigue me getting murdered.
Yeah, I'd like to not be murdered.
I mean, I don't know how strong that thing is, but we sure as hell didn't run away from it just for it to come and murder
doing
us.
Just to get the favor of a god?
What? We're getting a favor of a god, are we?
Aren't we? Isn't her mistress pretty much a god?
Yes.
I mean, if we do something good for her, it's getting her favor, isn't it?
Instant level 15.
That's way playing way too much meta.
Kidding.
I don't know. We can take a vote. So if we had any sort of actual assuredness in anything, I would be more likely. Like, if we were, like, basically screwed throughout this entire continent because of what had happened in Daggerfall, I would be more likely to want to leave as well.
On the one...
I feel like we should get away from there. I feel like...
We're already screwed in Daggerfall.
Yeah.
No. I mean, if the actions in Daggerfall... What continent or what country are we in right now?
Aurelia or something.
Aurelia. If our actions in Daggerfall affect our standing and viability to pursue finances in all of Aurelia... Sure, I would say.
Think about it. Lord Bannon is large and influential. If we're wanted in if he wants us in Daggerfall, won't he spread his network?
I don't know. To be fair, we haven't been convicted or of anything.
We haven't been in touch with civilization in a while.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure there's
like if you want, we can covertly go to a village and check on any news of us, and then we can decide. You want to do that?
That just seems like a way to shoehorn in a free story. I don't know. I'd say we have to take a vote.
We can decide after we find our standing in the country.
In the current point, I am not for going to Ice Crown.
Yeah, I understand. If you want to decide after we find our current standing in this country.
Sure.
Let's find our current island country in this country first, then find some random shitty village.
How much was the bounty on Red Eye again?
600k.
It's quite a lot.
Damn.
But five ways.
Is there any way for us to find out where the nearest village is?
There's a road, you could follow it until you hit something.
That's what I was assuming we do.
Yes.
Now
which way is Ice Crown on this road? Out of
I'm gonna guess north.
It's north, so
okay,
you can
I know,
go
but this road only
again.
Goes east and west.
Yep.
So
correct.
Either one could be correct.
Yeah.
Well,
at that point, we'd have to follow it. Thing.
Well no one bought a then. Map, so yeah.
I'm assuming yeah. You know where she's going. Unless you really
I think we should decide after getting supplies and at a village.
Sure. I mean, we're going east then. I'm assuming.
I assume also be cautious, just in case.
We came to Daggerfall from the west, right?
Yes.
Okay, then let's go east.
Yeah. Give me a second, I need to take something down.
Yeah, we're doing that.
You guys travel on the road or in the forest?
I think we can travel on the road safely. And
how far away is
the
forest from the road?
I mean, they're like right next to each other, basically.
Okay, then we're on the road.
Okay.
Well, like it's night
yeah,
now.
We should also...
east anyway, isn't it?
Sorry?
Like it's night right now, isn't it?
Probably rest.
We slept not that long ago, didn't we?
No.
I'm
sorry. Stayed up for like.
You slept in the
dead.
Cave.
You guys.
Oh yeah,
did.
You guys did.
I stayed watch, so I'm.
You stayed up the whole night. I thought we went to like put up all those alarms specifically
yeah,
so
you
everybody
guys all
could
went sleep.
To sleep.
Yeah,
so,
we did. We
yeah.
all slept.
Oh. Why am I not at full health then?
I don't know.
I'm not in the minutes because I thought there should be no matter.
Maybe yeah. I did too. I don't
know. Yeah, the door basically fucked you guys,
yeah,
that's why.
Door.
Yeah.
Took damage from that.
The poison
yeah.
fucked us up.
You should still have your dailies and your action points, so I think we're good to keep going unless people really want to stop.
I'm not that.
Well, the main reason
I'm...
I would want to stop is so the demon doesn't like attack us on the road. Or...
I know. I'm just thinking if the road is right beside the forest, we can duck into the forest.
I suppose.
Because that's what our plan was going down the plains anyway.
I guess.
Okay. I guess we can.
So I'm fine continuing on then.
Ow.
We should also be careful of like bandits on the side.
Highwaymen.
They're like. They could pop out of the forest at any time.
Just rob them back.
Wise. Yeah. We should be pretty watchful of all directions.
I mean, I'm assuming we have at least one torch out.
I'm gonna put my glasses on. Oh, I guess it's night.
They don't even work at night.
Yeah, never mind.
You look like that typical nerd from like all those, films. Those glasses on, basically. Okay, so wait, you guys stopping or you guys traveling?
Traveling. Is okay. Norath spelled with a K-N or just an N?
Just an N.
Okay.
Actually, I probably could post a list of all the factions. I'll do it later, I guess.
Just typing up some notes.
Okay, so how long are you guys going to travel for? Like, throughout the night or just like 6 hours and then stop? Or
we should
what?
Stop to heal.
Well, if you guys want to sleep, I mean, I guess we could go to, like, what? It's, like, 9 right now? You want to go to midnight and then sleep for, like, 6 hours?
That sounds fair.
Okay, so we go another 3 hours along the road. I don't know what we can see ahead of us, so keep us updated, because if, like, the forest ends, we might stop there.
Okay, do you guys light a torch, or do you guys just try and follow the road when it's dark?
We light a torch.
Light a torch.
Do
I don't want anybody tripping, breaking their ankle or something. Walking in the dark isn't safe.
Don't run with scissors.
Roll in the dark.
These roads are not like paved roads.
No, but they're traveled, so they're.
So they'll have nice big holes in them, probably.
Do we have. Like a stick, and we can sweep in front of us as usual.
It's gonna make us take forever. Was this late? Light a fucking torch!
As it makes us an easy target.
Do you really think a demon whose champion is Nightmare
sure
isn't
gonna
be able
like,
to see in the fucking night?
I think think.
Like, I'm thinking he's probably just going
to
know.
I realize, yes, the torch opens up to highwaymen, but I think that the six of us should be able to deal with them.
Yeah, I'm not that concerned about that, considering the other shit we've been through.
Okay.
I'd rather we didn't all break our legs, because I can promise you that Dallas probably has a leg-breaking roll or something in there.
What?
Every step we take.
Every step you take, roll an acrobatics check or something.
Like, yeah, I would have failed that already, so I think we're over. Just
okay,
so fine,
I'm lighting
light
my fucking torch. It's already lit. Deal with
okay.
it.
Wow, you're such a bad leader.
I'm not the one who got us wrapped up with this crazy bitch.
How is this my fault? She it's contacted
basically
me.
Basically all your fault.
Forget it. Drop it. Just go.
Alright. That, I think, is a list of all the factions. Notable factions.
Where is this being posted?
Google Docs.
Cool.
No, I mean, where did you post the link?
Teamspeak.
Okay.
So, yeah, those are all the notable factions, basically.
Jeez. Emboracum factions. Is Emboracum the world name?
The continent, yeah.
Okay. I'm just gonna add a link to this, I guess. Or I could add it to my Google Doc thing. Whatever, I'll keep it open. Oh, so these are this doesn't include the countries inside of the continents, I guess? Or are these continents or countries?
Those are countries.
So these countries are all part of one continent?
Yes.
And the continent is Emboracum?
Yes.
So Emboracum is not the world, then. It is a continent.
No, it is a continent.
Okay.
Content you are on.
Wow. There's a lot of places that have Hive City as a capital.
Well, I mean, the dwarven cities are all, like, in the mountains. So, I mean, it's basically like the city from The Hobbit, you know? It's, like, just built into the mountains, so it's
Central
not,
hub.
Like,
well, Harbeck, which faction are you from?
You can choose one.
I'm not
Stop
actually
snorting
a dwarf.
When you laugh.
Dude, he's a really mature halfling.
I don't even
know.
Yeah,
I mean, you can pick one if you want.
Where would giants live?
Giants, you would live in Redwall. Or the Redwall, which is basically a line of dormant volcanoes and mountains.
Where is that?
That's like far north. It's between Norath and Iceground, basically.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, that place sucked.
Is that why you left?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
How
We're
many
walking
talking
along
animals
the road.
Are there in Redwall?
What?
Never mind.
How many what?
He said talking how many talking animals, animals are there in Redwall.
Alright, yeah, isn't Redwall that place when the house
Oh yeah, the novel thing. Yeah, no.
I don't remember.
Okay,
you
remember
whatever.
Those mouse novels?
Oh, is that what it is? Oh my god, you're right! Oh. Fuck those books. Okay, let's go. Let's go on the road. For 3 hours. Okay.
Yeah, so you go for 3 hours, and you guys are like near the edge of a forest.
Okay,
maybe
so Athenia is just cool with this, by the way? She didn't really say anything.
Yeah, she's fine
cool
if you guys want to follow her.
So we just happen to be going the same way?
Well, I mean, if you want to help her get to her mistress, then yeah, it's fine.
No, I know. I'm just saying she was also planning on going east.
I'm going north eventually, but I mean, I can't get past the mountains at this point of the land, so I'll have to find another way around.
Okay.
Isn't she planning to go along with her, but I'm trying to find out what the hell is happening first?
Yeah, like,
I'd
we,
assume
we
that
we
she's okay. Yeah, I'd assume that she's okay with tagging along with us up until our decision to help her or not.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So let's go.
Okay. Yeah, you guys travel along for like 3 hours, and you guys are reaching the edge of the forest. If you guys travel for another hour, you guys will reach the end.
So we've traveled for 3 hours?
Yes.
And we're near the edge of the forest?
Yeah.
Alright. Do you guys want to take a nap here then?
6 hour nap.
I guess you guys can't really sleep again, because you've already slept for 6 hours this day. That'd be kind of weird if you guys just passed out again.
Oh, I could do that.
Yeah, because you guys... Yeah,
So, I mean, you guys, I don't think you guys could take a full rest. Yeah, you'd have to be up for another, I think, 8 hours before you could actually take a full rest like that. So you guys can chill out for now.
Well, I mean, what do they have to do to be able to use a healing surge or whatever?
You just have to chill out and not do anything strenuous.
For how long?
An hour per healing surge. Or two, because you guys have a cleric, but yeah. Two healing surges per hour since you have a cleric.
Okay, well then I guess we'll wait for an hour.
Okay. Good.
So our sleep schedules are just completely fucked? We can't just force ourselves to fall asleep?
I think you guys can fall asleep every 12 hours and take a full rest. I think that was the rule. So yeah. Eh. Because I mean, it's not physically possible to get like two full nights of rest between 6 hours, I don't think.
Just
so.
Yeah. Sleep indefinitely until the problems go away.
I mean, I guess you guys can drink yourself silly. I don't think anyone has any booze on you. Or actually, I don't know. Harpic, do you have any blueberry mead left?
You can just drink some of my blood.
I specifically have a bottle of wine. It's in my inventory.
Okay, whatever. I guess right. We'll just... We chilled out for an hour.
Use your fucking you healing surges based, if you need it. I'm completely...
Yep.
Like, already done. Already. Alright, so. Plan of action. Let's keep going, right?
There you go. Yep. Might as well. I mean, we haven't heard anything or seen anything, right?
No, I mean, you hear some coyotes off in the forest, but they don't come near you, so...
Oh, okay. Fuck. Hey, coyotes, let's turn around.
Let's keep
okay.
going east, then.
So, I guess you guys travel until you hit a town, right?
I mean, yeah, I'm assuming we would see it at some point.
Yeah, you guys, like, travel until morning, I guess?
Can't sleep, I'm pretty sure we're gonna
we'll
keep
travel
going.
We'll travel until I guess we either reach a town or we've been thoroughly exhausted for. Yeah.
Yeah, so you guys go for like, what was it? That's about 12 now, so you guys go for another 12 hours. I guess you guys take short rests along the way. And then eventually you guys see a town up ahead. I guess you guys just walk in.
We observe it first?
Okay, there are some first impression you get, wooden walls, not very thick, not very high. They seem to be, you know, basics to keep small incursions from coming in, so like goblins or something like that, or bandits from, you know, just walking in. And there are some gates and some watchtowers near them. The town...
Is it still dark?
What?
Is it still dark?
It's 12 p.m.
Okay.
Yeah, so the population, you... Based on how big it is, it's approximately like 50,000 people, you would imagine. Like a small town, or it's a medium-sized town. And yeah, there are guard posts, so there's signs of a garrison.
Do we see any banners or bannermen associated with what we've known or seen already?
Yeah, Aurelian army.
Okay.
We could have someone disguise and go in and ask around.
I guess.
Or, actually, wait, would they be looking for Athenian? Specifically?
Probably not. But I don't want to do that because there's really no guarantee she's going to come back.
So, who of us.
Do we really think we're that screwed?
I don't know, that's the thing.
I don't think only one person should go. That's a recipe for getting fucked.
Okay.
I think we should send two people minimum.
Okay, well, I'm fairly good at bluffing my way through things.
I can bluff, but I think I'm barely noticeable.
I'm pretty stealthy, too.
Are you going to try to sneak around, or are you going to talk to people?
Well, I mean, I'm assuming that stealth goes along with, like, disguise.
Disguises, yeah.
Yep.
I guess if you're just getting basic information, sure.
Who else wants to join me?
I have a decent stealth,
was.
But I would my being a tiefling be against a negative to disguising?
No.
I'll go with.
There's nothing. There's nothing in the rule books about that, so I'll just say no.
Okay, I'll go with them.
Okay.
How should we disguise ourselves?
We have fake mustaches.
Wigs.
You have wigs.
Wow, we still have the wigs, right?
I believe so. Did you guys discard them?
I have them.
I never said I threw it out. I don't know if I'm still wearing it.
I was assuming I took them back.
Wait, I can't even wear a wig.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, you can-ish, I guess.
Am I just gonna slip it under the helmet?
Oh yeah, that's right, you have the helmet. I guess you can't wear a wig.
Also, your face is completely revealed if you're wearing the helmet, so maybe you shouldn't go.
I mean, you could put a hood over you, but you have, like, it looks just so awkward.
It looks so stupid.
Does the helmet not close face?
Somebody other than Davros, no. Go, please. I can go, but I'm not stealthy.
Yeah, if someone asked me to remove my helmet, that'd be just weird.
Okay. So, yeah. You guys walk on up to the gates.
Who's you guys? Wait.
So, Rayon and Davros, right?
No, we just said
he's
Davros
not gonna do it because he has
go.
The helmet on.
Oh, okay, so just Rayon.
I mean, I could bluff my way through.
Not just
Rayon.
Somebody else is going with him. If nobody else volunteers, I guess I'll go. I have totally fine, like, streetwise and intimidation shit. I just don't have any stealth, so if you want to sneak around, I can't really do
that. I do not have anything that would be remotely useful in me.
Wait, hang on. This helmet isn't closed face?
No.
Okay.
I mean, it should
looks
be
like...
fine, right? Even if it's not closed face, it'd be pretty hard to recognize with a helmet on.
I don't know how you got it on your head in the first place.
No, I was just saying that the fact that you're wearing the helmet means you can't really wear a hood, means that your tieflingness is completely revealed.
I mean, like, you can't... I mean...
So if you think that's going to be an issue, I would suggest against
it. I don't think it's specifically an issue. I don't think they're specifically looking... I mean, like, pretty sure there's more than one tiefling.
Okay. Go for it. You guys go.
Let's just go for it.
Okay, so Rayon and Davros both walk up to the gates.
Let's get our story straight first.
Yeah, let's get our story straight.
What are we?
Do we have anything to sell? Could we be merchants?
Oh, I don't have anything, man.
Don't have any.
I'll be a fortune teller.
I'll be a entertainer. Whoever can take the helmet off my head can. Earn money.
Someone try and chop off your head, man.
I don't know.
Wait, but that tapestry said that people use that area in times of peril to escape. What if this is the town where they escape to?
Seems a bit too coincidental.
Okay, fair enough.
I mean.
But, like, if someone recognizes the helmet, they're like, oh, what have you done? You released the champion of the
league. That tapestry is old, too, right? Is there even a chance this village was here back then?
That's true. Okay. I'm just worrying about nothing, I guess. So I'm a fortune teller. I'll be Damien the fortune teller.
I'll just be a traveler.
And, yeah, you can be my traveling companion.
Yeah. Someone's asking me, I just say I got cursed with this helmet. I'm trying to find a way to remove it.
Okay.
Or so I could use the magic from your helmet to read the fortunes of the place. I'll like put my hands around your head and go woo.
The curse that's
supposed to drop your curse. Hands all across his face.
Pick his nose for fortunes. Okay, let's do that. Not the picking the nose part, obviously. Okay.
Yeah, so you guys walk to the gates, the guards say, halt, get your business.
I'm the great traveler. And fortune teller, Damien. This is my traveling companion. We wish to... How would I say that? We wish, like, to showcase our acts of... what's the word for this? Foresight? I think?
Wish to con the people?
Law. We wish to show our... Showcase our talent.
Do business.
And your name was Damien?
Damien.
Okay. And he pulls out a scroll and writes down. And you are what? And points at you, Davros.
Benjamin.
Don't go cause any trouble around here, alright? The boys got their eye on you.
We heard some ruckus up in the main city. Was there something happening?
Yep. About some people trying to kill Lord Bannon.
Oh my, that's terrible.
Yeah.
They catch them?
Haven't heard anything from them. Riders came in last night. Yeah. They should be dead, though. City is on lockdown. Doubt they're coming out.
Okay. So we don't have any worry of them coming here.
That's a relief.
No, no, no.
Okay.
Okay, thanks.
Alright, head on in. Don't cause any trouble.
Thank you.
Right. Maybe while we're here, we can research your helmet.
Yeah, I guess. Probably should get some supplies first, too.
Yeah, that too.
Okay, what's it? It's just money. You guys. What's everyone else doing, though, right now?
Jacking off.
Yeah, I was about to say that.
You guys just sitting like
a. Athenia's just sitting there watching us.
Okay. Are you guys, like. So, are you guys on the road, or are you guys, like, just off the road to the side?
I mean, how far away is the forest from the town?
There is no forest. You guys are, like, hills now. The forest ended. Yeah.
I guess we're just. Is there anything? Is there shrubbery?
I mean, if you walked off the road for like an hour, you'd hit some farmland.
Are there any rocks?
Not really, no.
Ditches,
you might be able to find one.
I don't know.
We'll make a house.
Go hang out in a ditch or something off the road, I guess.
Okay.
Somewhere off the road, because we're not just going to stand in the middle of the road.
Yeah, okay.
Could rob people.
Yeah, we could. But you're not here. I mean, so I assume we do nothing.
Yeah, I'm kind of just doing.
We could just steal all of Ithania's.
And then I find like a piece of wood and like carve it into like a sculpture.
Yeah.
Sure.
We could just steal into? All of Ithania's things and leave her stranded on the side of the road.
Well, let's kill Ithania.
Yeah.
Oh god.
And just leave everybody.
You and me, Harbeck, will tour the world together. You can come too if you want, Aladir.
Nah.
This is split into two separate stories.
I'm assuming that's gonna
split
happen.
Split the party.
I don't know. Sure.
So yeah.
While wait, you guys wait, are... wait, 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 wait. Does anybody want a fake sword fight with my spinal cords?
No. Not at all.
You're gross.
Yeah. So,
I do have an erection.
While you guys are in a ditch, roll a perception check.
Absolutely.
Amazing
at those.
What's my bonus again? I haven't like rolled anything. Oh, this entire session.
Okay. Yeah. Well, I'll do it.
I'm not gonna
basically.
Roll.
Oh yeah.
Who is this Dustin H?
No, I reroll. It doesn't count. Shit.
Wow.
Yeah, so while you guys are in a ditch, you guys see a child like at the top of the ditch, and he's looking down at you guys. And when you guys and Aldir, when you meet eyes with him, he runs off.
Ah, shit. You guys see that?
Wait, how did this child walk up onto us unawares?
Oh,
we're all jacking off in the ditch.
That's why I told you guys to roll a perception check.
Okay, watch out.
I'm confused. This child just walked up to us and we didn't see him?
You did. Elder saw him.
Yeah, but we clearly got close enough to see
you were
us.
In a ditch.
You're in a ditch doing nothing.
I don't know. What's Ithania doing?
In the ditch with you?
Meditating.
Has the child seen us?
He saw Aladir and ran off. Like, yeah. You guys met eyes and then he ran off.
We totally look like bandits. Guys.
Climb out of the ditch and shoot him in the head.
Wait, whoa, where is he running off to?
He's running back to the town. Or he's running back to the farmlands.
Burn the town.
How far away are we from town?
I believe you guys were an hour away. Oh, no, not an hour away. You guys would have been at the edge of town, so I'll say like 30 minutes away.
So how far away is he from the farm? He's 30 minutes away from the farm?
Yeah.
And he just peeked over the ditch?
Yeah.
How old is he?
I guess at 27, you would estimate between the age of 10 and 12.
Okay, we can easily fucking catch him then.
Why?
I'm not saying we need to, I'm just saying we could. This is all split second shit, by the way, so this is probably cheating. You're just gonna let him run off?
Well, I'm not gonna fucking.
I'm not saying we kill him!
I'm not gonna lay out a kid.
Maybe we just catch him and then knock him out and go bring him back to the farm and say we found this kid knocked out. Good deed!
Maybe they'll pay us.
Fine, oh we just God. Let him run away?
I don't know. We should probably go somewhere else. Because we look like bad people.
Yeah, I think maybe just change locations. For
sure, fine. Let's just let him run away. I'm just going to yell after him, "Hi, nice to meet you."
What? Wait, what time is it right now?
Yeah, afternoon. What the fuck? What time is it?
Afternoon.
The afternoon.
Oh.
12 p.m.
Jesus.
He said that already.
For a long time, then.
He said we were walking for 12 hours.
My legs are tired.
Blisters like everywhere.
That's why I should have went to town. Okay, yeah.
Okay, I guess we move locations to the other side of the road or something. And now we look around for people. Oh, it's gonna look suspicious, I guess. I don't fucking know. We just wait in another ditch, or what do you guys want to do?
Why do you need to be in the ditch?
I don't know, because it keeps us out of sight. I don't want to just be standing on the side of the road.
Go climb a tree.
There's no trees! I asked Dallas that.
No, yeah, there's no trees forest. Right now. Well, I mean, there's like a tree somewhere in the middle of fucking nowhere, but I mean, it's not gonna cover you guys so much. You can sit under it.
Exactly.
But there's no thickening of trees, yeah.
Are there any rocks to lean against so we don't look as suspicious?
Yeah, I mean, I guess you find
let's
a rock
all just
in the
start
ditch.
Whistling.
Sure, let's just lean against the fucking rock or something, right. And then we'll just say that we're taking a rest or whatever. Somebody
start a fire.
Tend to be asleep.
I guess there's no wood.
Okay, whatever. We go back to whatever we were doing, but we're keeping semi-watch while we lean against this rock. Yeah. I'm just gonna keep watching the kid.
But the kid ran off back to the farm now. He's out of your sight.
Okay. It's fucking fast. I thought it was supposed to be a half hour.
Well, I mean, you guys just walk. You guys are walking away from him, so I mean, yeah, he gives him a shit ton of time to run back to the farm.
I know. It's still like a half hour, you said.
Yeah, but I mean, he's out of your sight like, at some point. Anyways, right. Yeah, back in the town, Rayon and Davros, what do you guys do?
I guess, Davros, like you were saying, we should get some supplies first.
Yeah, I'll
makes sense.
How much money do you have on you?
I'm pretty wealthy right now.
Okay, I got like 700.
Oh, okay. I'm pretty wealthy right now. Let's keep it like that.
Okay. Oh, okay.
Like 3,000 gold wealthy.
Oh, okay. I was just wondering why specifically I didn't need to know, but I was like, okay, that's fine with me.
Alright, so let's go to
General Store?
General Store?
Okay. What do you guys buy?
Group rations.
Bread and jam.
Bread and jam?
Yeah, the guy says, yeah. He can sell you, I think, Journey's bread for... Where's the... Oh, how much is... There we go. Okay, Oh, wow. Okay, you can buy 10 days worth of rations for 50 gold. That's one person.
10 days or 50?
So that would be two days for the party.
50 gold, a lot? I guess 10 days worth of food is a lot, too.
Yeah.
That still sounds like a lot of money.
Yeah.
That's for one person.
Yeah, it still sounds like a lot.
So wait, if I wanted to buy for 5 people, you could still supply that?
I could supply you 20 days for 100 gold.
20 days for 100 gold? 20 days for one person?
Yes.
What if I told you that I was the world's greatest fortune teller?
Oh my god.
I don't have any interest in fortune. My faith lies with Taylor.
Taylor.
Hang on.
Taylor. Let's find this in the notes.
I'm trying to think, how much would 10 days worth of food be? 10 days worth of food would be just...
Well, that's like breakfast, lunch, and dinner, so, yeah. So, that's 3 meals, so one day would be 10 gold.
I mean, 50 gold is still oil.
Oh, wait, no, sorry. That's 5 gold for one day, so it's 5 meals. It's 3 meals for 5 gold, so there you go.
Dallas, that's how do you spell Paylor?
Paylor, P-E-L-O-R.
Wow. I didn't have it in my notes anywhere. Maybe I misspelled it earlier.
Well, I mean, Paylor is just a generic god from the rulebook, so, I mean, you don't really need to write that down, 50? I feel like.
Oh, that's what you're basing it off of, the journey. Okay, that's not too bad.
Okay. Yeah. We'll take it.
Okay. So, yeah, someone cough up 100 gold.
I shall do that.
Okay.
100 gold is only for two people, right?
Yep. Well, I mean, you get 20 days worth of food, so, yeah, it's for one person, so you have to split that after.
Okay. Do you have any flasks of oil?
Oil? What kind of oil?
Just
or like
typical
lamps?
Lamp oil.
Yeah, I do, actually.
I have some flasks here. Would it be cheaper to use my own flasks?
Sure, I can give it... I can give you... Well, how many flasks do you have?
I have... Hang on, I think I remember I gave one away, so I have four.
Four? Okay, yeah, that's four silver.
I hand him four silver. Also, do you have a torch? Unlit torch?
Unlit torches, sure. I can. It's one silver a piece, or one silver a stick.
So five silver total.
Want five torches? Okay, yeah.
Sure. No. I want four flasks and one torch.
Okay, that's five silver total.
Okay, so hang on, I need to.
What the hell just happened?
Also, actually, no, I'm not gonna do that.
Holy shit!
I'm trying to think what else I can do here. I can't think of anything else. I think that's it then.
That shit just happened.
What?
What?
I don't know what I accidentally bought, and I spent like 1,500 gold on something.
Oh, well.
What?
Just give yourself your gold back and remove 100, I guess? Or not 100, I was at 20 gold.
I just keep my gold amount counted in, like, separately from the actual character builder thing.
Yeah, the character builder's kind of crap for that, I feel like, but,
yeah.
Okay, so, Davros, do you go to look into your helmet at all, or what?
Oh, right, that was it. Ask him if he's seen anything about this helmet, like, in, like, maybe, like, folklore around here?
No? Is it some kind of replica?
No, but I can't seem to remove it.
Well, there's a wizarding university in Daggerfall. You can go there. I'm sure someone knows how to deal with that there.
Oh. Okay. I just thought maybe someone around here would know something since I picked it up from around here.
Well, there is a guy. He lives, and then he gives you some directions to some street. But I don't know. He's kind of a kook, if you ask me. Does some weird stuff. Collects all kinds of weird things, like glowing worms or whatever. I don't understand them wizard folk.
Thanks for your help.
Those fucking glowing worms.
Oh man.
Wait. Before, do you sell? Do you have any potions?
Potions? What kind of potions are you looking for?
Just typical, like, maybe recovery ones.
Healing potions? Oh, of course. I got one here, actually. 100 gold. Only
one?
Yep.
Out of character, would I be able to sense if a healing potion was legit through magic? Like, would it have magic in it, or is it just made through herbs?
It's just, alchemy. So yeah, if you got swindled, you'd have to go back and kick his ass, basically, but, you know.
Yeah, let me see. Would that be dungeoneering to check, like, through, like, wafting the smell to check?
I decided it would be healing, because that's the closest thing you can get.
I ask Rayon whether or not he is...
Actually, I'll allow you to use either Arcana or healing. One of the two will work.
Arcana or healing?
Yeah, because it's basically... Alchemy is kind of, I guess, magical ingredients. Okay. So, it's like... This fourth head doesn't really do potion crafting all too well.
Okay. I ask, no offense, but do you mind if I check?
You don't trust my product?
I don't trust anyone that I don't personally know for a while.
Took him a while to...
Fair, roll of diplomacy.
Let me see. My diplomacy. Actually, wait, can I use the... Yeah, I'll do Beguiling Tongue, it's encounter.
Does that give you bonus to diplomacy?
Yeah, or plus 5.
Oh, well, okay. Says, well, I suppose. Guess you can't trust anyone these days. You hear about some people trying to murder Lord Bannon? He invited him into his house and they tried killing him in the night. Weird shit, man.
The guard told us about that. Do you know anything else?
No, they just... They locked down the city, apparently. A bunch of merchants... Some merchants came by here early in the day, really pissed off that they couldn't get in to sell their stuff.
24 is Arcana.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, based on what you, I guess, sense from it. Like I said, you wafted it, and... Yeah, based on the color and everything else, you can tell it's pretty legit.
Okay. Sorry for doubting you, but here's your gold. How much is it?
100.
Throw him 100 gold.
Well, thank you, sir. Have a good day now.
I tried
Wait,
to write...
Is this wizard's name possibly someone we might know the name? I forget now.
Phelan? Faron? Phelan? Faron? F something?
Guys, help. I can look at my note. Fulwin. There we
Fulwin.
Go.
Fulwin? No. Name's Benjamin.
Hello. Okay, we'll go to speak with this Benjamin.
Okay, thank you. Have a good day. When we exit the shop, I look around to see if anyone's close enough to hearing distance. Anyone?
Oh, as in, like...
Like, if I whisper to Rion, would anyone be able to see, hear it? Like, no. Are we on a busy street? Okay.
No,
like,
not really.
Turn to Rion, like, doesn't seem like it's spread too far yet, but it's currently contained in Daggerfall. If they find out we've escaped, they probably will spread their...
Yeah.
Probably shouldn't stay too long in case they send riders out.
Yeah.
Just get
Agreed.
Out. Yeah, let's just finish our business and get out of here.
Okay.
I guess we take Benjamin.
Benjamin? Okay. So yeah, you go to like this... It looks like you've gone to a bit of the shittier part of town, basically. The houses stopped looking as... Well, I mean, the houses here weren't that great to begin with. They were, you know, just made of simple wood and, you know, crappy window. But then these ones, it looks like the roofs are pretty much falling apart. So, yeah, you approach this house, and you see a kid outside. And he sees you and just runs inside.
The kid?
Yeah.
Suppose we go knock on the door?
Okay. You knock on the door and someone yells, "Yes, who is it?"
Are you Benjamin? We've come to ask a couple questions.
Now the door opens. You see this old man, like this kid hiding behind him. He says, "Oh, what do you need?"
Folks around here said you might know something about your helmet.
Examines your helmet. Why? What's so special about the helmet?
Can't take it off.
Oh. Well, I can help you. It'll cost you. Well, I might be able to help you, but it'll cost you.
Might be able to help me. Can I get some inclination as to what kind of help this is?
Well, I'll see what I can do to take it off, and then if I find a solution, it'll cost you.
Are you a wizard?
Yes. And he pulls out this book from underneath his robe.
Oh, okay. Sure, you can try.
Alright. Go on
Actually,
inside.
First, how much would it cost me?
It depends how hard it is to remove.
If you find a method that does remove it, would you tell me how much it costs first before doing it?
Sure.
Okay.
Probably gonna need materials for it anyways.
Go ahead and try.
Alright. So, yeah, he goes and gets some alchemy materials and just kind of sprinkles it over the helmet and, like, waves his hands over your head and he says, it's on there pretty good. Where'd you get this helmet again?
I have picked it up from, like, some random cave around here. Turns out it was cursed, it looks like. Not too sure.
Well, I'm sorry to say, this is actually probably beyond my skill.
Okay. First, I thought it was stuck to my horns.
Oh, it appears to be stuck to your head. If you removed it, it'd probably just rip your head clean off.
Do you have potentially anything for? Do you have any anti-venom or antidotes?
Antidotes. I know a bit of alchemy. What do I need an antidote for?
I'm not too sure what it is, but do I know what I'm poisoned with, Dallas?
I think Aladir knew what you were poisoned with.
Yeah, I didn't ask him.
No, you did not.
I did.
Yeah, you did the heal check.
I don't know what it was, but it came from like a gas.
Well, that's kind of vague. Here, yeah. Sit down here. I'll inspect you. You pay me a gold.
Yeah, my gold.
Okay. Yeah, so he does like a doctor's check on you. You know, kind of looks at your mouth, peels back your eyelids and everything. Says, "Oh, okay. Try coughing." Yeah, you cough.
Yeah.
Maybe a bit of blood. And he says, "Okay, yeah, I know what's wrong with you. I can cure you. I guess that would be pay me 200 gold, and I can have the cure ready by tomorrow."
By tomorrow?
Yep. Take a night to brew.
Don't know if we can stay here that long.
Can't help you.
Would it be possible to brew it myself if you taught me how?
Oh, sure. Does anyone have crafting of any kind? I think it's a feat.
The feat?
Yeah, I think it's a feat. Does anyone? Actually, I think it's called rituals. You don't have rituals.
There's thievery, streetwise, stealth, religion, perception.
No, it's a feat. It's a feat. Not
feat. Feat, not a.
Oh, I don't know.
Do not.
Arbeck?
Oh, is it called elves?
What?
If you receive the ritual. Is it called Alchemist?
I think so.
It says if you receive the ritual caster feat as a class feature, you can take the. Oh, no, we do not. Fuck. So we actually need to.
It would be harder. You basically would lose proficiency, so.
What would losing proficiency do? Just.
You wouldn't have a +5 to it, basically. Yeah, so I think that's how it's going to go down from now. It'll just be your intelligence or wisdom +5 if you have the feat or not for potions.
Still accept the lesson. How much does it cost to learn?
What?
Nala! How much does it cost to learn?
I can just write down the recipe for you, but if you want to do that, I'll give it to you for 100 gold.
Sure, I'll pay him 100.
Sure.
Hang on, I need to. So I paid 100 for the healing potion, 100 for this, and 1 gold, so 201.
201, yeah.
Okay. So now I have the recipe for a. Is it specifically for this kind of poison?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, he tosses you a couple of jars of, like, you know. A weird slug, some kind of sludge. A rat tail.
Okay.
It gives you the instructions to it, too.
Okay. I thank him for his time.
Alright.
I'd like to ask one thing first.
Sure.
You didn't happen to hear a loud screeching howl last night, did you?
Heard some coyotes.
I don't think it was a coyote.
What would it be?
Something a lot scarier. Hope is not going to be too.
Okay. Take care now.
Thanks. You too.
Alright.
We should probably leave the city now, legit. I think we have everything we need.
Yeah. Get out of here.
I suppose if the guards ask why we're leaving so early, just say no one here wants our business.
The guards, they don't give a shit.
Oh, okay.
They're pretty slack. Okay, so yeah, you guys leave the city and meet up with the other group, I guess?
We don't know where they are.
Oh.
We're, like, visible from the side.
Are you? Oh, okay.
I'm just hanging out.
That guys are still in the ditch.
No, they moved from the ditch. Okay, so you guys regroup.
Okay, tell them what we knew. What we know.
Okay.
It doesn't seem like shit's gonna happen in relatively soon, but you know, within time they might send troops out to search outside the city.
Yeah.
Lord Bannon is after us.
He's making up lies, apparently.
Oh,
or exactly somebody else tried to kill him.
Not exactly something we can easily refute.
Yeah. Well, I mean, none of this really changes my opinion. Like, the guards don't have, obviously, direct, like...
Yet.
Recognition, yet. And we're gonna keep heading far away. Yeah, you can shut up, I know where your fucking feelings lie. So I'm not gonna be convincing you about anything. I don't know, did it change anybody else's opinion?
Not really.
Okay, so what would you guys do if we didn't go? No.
Pursue work elsewhere. Maybe it leads us along the road similar to Ithania for a while. Maybe it doesn't. I don't.
So you would plan to just tag along in this direction until something were to fall in your lap, essentially, and work. You don't know. You have no assurance whatsoever.
Look for stuff. Yeah.
You could go to another town and there's bound to be something.
Yeah. But you have to go to the next country over, maybe.
Why?
Like, eventually, he is going to look for us elsewhere. Because he thinks we're still in the city.
Okay. How big of a deal do you really think this is to Bannon?
At the very least, the city and the surrounding area.
How big of a deal do you think it is when Ithania is not with us? Because it's her that is the problem.
Well, let's see. Did slaughter an entire house of his men. Freed his prisoner.
Because of you. It's Ithania he wants at the end.
And we ran away.
They're not going to chase us across the country.
They will, because he's accusing us of attempting to murder him.
I don't think they are, so...
What? No, we heard directly.
That's literally what they've been saying.
No, I know. I know that. I just don't think that he's going to bother chasing us if we don't have Ithania.
I dispute that entirely.
I don't know how we would know that.
Like, what evidence do you have that would lead you to that?
So you're saying we have to flee the entire country and we might as well just go with her?
Yeah. Well, I have other reasons too, but...
Yeah, I know. That's why arguing with you is worthless. Because I'm not going to sway your opinion.
But I'm still trying to sway yours.
Yeah, I know. I'm very much aware of that.
So...
I don't know. I have my own thoughts. Is anybody else going to say anything? Or is this going to be me and Tuba talking to each other?
I don't really know what to
do. Rayon.
Because otherwise we're just going to sit here at a stalemate for a while until somebody decides to do something.
I mean, it's up to you. I mean, you're the one...
Well, does every town have, like, a bounty board?
Yep. Well, I mean, any...
They will, but currently
anything
we're
that's,
not on.
Like, a town or above, like, a town or above. A small, shitty village, probably not.
So, is walls. This place we're outside of right now a small, shitty village?
No, it's a town.
It's a town, isn't it?
It has an actual garrison, so...
Alright.
Like, the news hasn't reached this far yet, so we're currently safe, but I think it will eventually.
Okay.
Like, Daggerfall is big, but they have a lot of guards and soldiers from which they can utilize to search and scour the entire city. As soon as they realize that we're not there.
At the very least, if they're not actively looking for us, there's still going to be a wanted out on us.
Possibly.
Not possibly.
There's nothing that
we fleed the town.
Nobody knows
when
that.
When we were
well, yeah,
under
they don't
a
know
contract
that yet. That's why
with Lord Bannon.
Did we sign anything? I don't remember, honestly.
No, we did not sign anything, but we were under a quest with him. We were about to leave the day of, but the night before we did all that stuff.
Oh, is
that's
what you're
why
saying
we left.
Is they don't know that we did it?
They don't know that we did anything. Why do you guys assume they're after us? There's no
because
evidence of that.
If Bannon is connected to Red Eye and so is that demon knows what we look like. I'm assuming they can talk to the demon.
That's a stretch, considering what? We just released it.
That's why I said it.
They even know it exists.
To the demon?
There's no evidence
of that. I
think
they were related.
Like, you guys are making a bunch of stretches to fill in knowledge gaps of which we do not know. We don't even know if they're after us, first off.
Why else would there be a... I mean, even... Dania said the demon was related to, like, what the Wanderer for.
Yeah.
They wanted someone...
Like, Red Eye is after...
I'd have to assume the reason
the mistress
a giant
for power.
Demon
yeah,
the
and
city.
He wants to use the ring to summon more demons.
Yeah,
that's what
Dania
Arcania
says, if it's too much trouble, you guys can just be on your way and perhaps it would be...
You cut out entirely there. I don't know what you're saying anymore.
Damn it. She says, if you think it'd be easier, we could just go our separate ways and perhaps you guys would be better off.
Yeah, we've been saying that. I'm just saying there's the people in the village never said how many people they were looking for, did they?
We didn't ask.
No, we didn't ask
specifics.
That's
kind of an important thing.
Didn't want to pry too much in case they thought...
That's fair enough. I'm just saying that there's no actual evidence that anybody is looking for us. Specifically.
So you're going to put your entire life on the line?
If you want to be more specific, you could go up and ask.
Yeah, I mean, I don't really think it's... I'm taking a huge risk. I think it's a lot riskier to traverse an entire country traveling with a person... who is being actively pursued by this person. Like, really, I don't really understand how you can argue that that's more safe.
That's fair to say, yeah. That's a fair point. It's not laughable, it's a fair point.
So, currently, my feeling is to possibly not get a bounty in this town, but to go to the next somewhat larger city and look for bounties. That's my opinion.
And if you're so hard set on doing that, I'm going to have to split ways.
Okay.
What? Really?
Josh is clearly just chasing after Ithania now. It's been quite obvious
for some time.
He's going to follow her no matter what.
Right, okay. I mean, at that point, if you do run off with her, then...
Then you just follow their story.
Well, I mean, it would basically, you would be recreating a character at that point because you'd be retiring your character because I'm not going to, like, do two
giant...
I understand. Yeah.
I'm still waiting for anybody else to say fucking anything.
I have no idea what I'm doing.
I'm probably ahead with Rayon because I'm more interested in that.
Like, okay, I'll break character for a second. I'm trying to play as a character. And
yeah,
I'm sorry, Dallas, but the situation has been built in such a way that it's not logically viable from my point of view to follow Ithania. I do agree that's where the more interesting story is.
I have a plan if you guys deviate from this character. So it's perfectly fine if you want to just ditch this character right now. It's fine.
My character is a warlock. I'm interested in demons. I'm going to follow that path.
Okay.
And I have my own reason for that, so... It's up to you guys.
It's basically up to Aladir and Harbeck then.
I don't know, I'm just a humble adventurer.
Yeah, same with me. If anything, I just want to get my name cleared in some way. And if that would mean either just getting as far away as possible from here, whatever that might entail, would be my choice, I guess.
That is nowhere near to getting your name cleared.
Well, I know, but I can't do that. So I just have to, like, leave. If I have to leave the country, then I guess that's what I have to do.
There is also the possibility, like Hrothgar said, potentially you don't know. I mean, it is possible, but... I feel like Lord Bannon had some inkling of what we were doing.
I don't know. It really depends what the majority does, I guess, because I don't want to split off from the group on my own, because that's just a death sentence in this point.
Well, no, we just reroll characters.
Well, yes, but
from the sounds
I'm still
of it, yeah, but from the sounds of it, it would be. It sounds like you three want to do your branch off thing, like not follow this story. And from that, it's fine. Then I just reroll, and I guess Davros would too.
I'm fine rerolling.
Is there any way, since we haven't mentioned this, to contact what's her name, Yasoka?
Oh yeah,
now that we're outside of Daggerfall.
Yeah. Well, possibly, assuming they didn't destroy the shrine that was in Nora.
Oh, so we'd have to go all the way to Nora to talk to her?
Yes.
Is there seriously no faster way to Nora than 3 months of travel?
You can buy some horses, or you can find some griffins.
Griffins? That's fucking awesome.
Perception check.
Can anyone talk to animals?
Yeah.
I don't think anyone can.
Doesn't Ithania have riches herself, or is some sort of higher power thing?
What?
Isn't Ithania herself some sort of, like, have some sort of high position or something?
No. Well, I am a priest, but my powers are still limited. I'm not a god.
No, I know. I mean more in terms of monetary or whatever, something.
Well, what would you want me to do?
The main thing is I want some sort of assurance that we're actually going to get paid in some form for anything, because we are mercenaries.
Well,
foremost.
Let's think of it this way. Even if you don't get the ring, you can still have a chance of catching Red Eye and getting the bounty on his head.
Yeah, but he's really fucking dangerous.
Well, so would any other quest that would give you a large bounty.
Yeah, I know, but that's also a shit ton of time of traveling. Yeah. Like, we're going to have to spend a fair sum of our money on rations and other equipment for traveling for 3 to 6 months for the chance, as you said, to catch him.
Right.
That's just so, like...
So, yeah, if you want to split paths, that's perfectly fine.
I don't know.
All right, we've taken far too long in this. I say just go with what your heart says. We'll do a vote right now, and then we'll figure it out.
I mean, in terms of character, Aladir, what are you exactly? You just want adventure?
Pretty much. I'm an explorer, so I want to see new sights, basically.
Would this quest interest your character at all? Like,
I don't know. I'm thinking about, like, I'm not sure, honestly, myself. I think
probably, yeah.
Do
we need to take a break and, like, come back at a next session and have people
Yeah, probably, because I don't think anyone really has a clear definition of goals. There's a lot of trying to get out of this session. Well, okay, you do, but, like, everyone else, I don't have a clear definition of what your goals are, so I'm trying to structure a campaign according to that. But I don't have a clear definition right now.
I think I'd be into it. It's just I have to weigh the options. No, I think I'd probably want to head north because that's just where it seems to be where the action is.
Okay. And Harbeck, your goal was just gold?
I want to travel around and spread the good name of my god through helping people and making money on the side. So I've bitten off more than I can chew with this little adventure that we've had here, and now I'm just trying to get out of it and restart.
Okay.
Well, I guess that
you know what? I have a proposition. If we get a reward, and it is in monetary value, since the thing that Rayon is getting out of this is that he is going to heal his father, I want Rayon's share of the treasure.
I'm okay if you want to split it equally, but not just you. That's unfair.
Yeah, I mean, he's basically saying split it 4 ways instead of 5, I think, right?
Yeah.
I guess.
I'll just give it all as well.
It's not what I was saying at all, but...
No, definitely not.
Okay.
Yeah, no, because you're a greedy fucking whore.
Very pretty conscious, this character.
So that's really all it takes.
Well, I mean... Possibly. I may split ways as we go. Depends on how dangerous it gets.
Okay, no. That's not how it goes.
Why, you're not signing me into a contract.
Why not?
I mean, you're asking for money in return for...
No, yeah, but the money wouldn't be delivered until we finish this quest anyway.
That's a contract!
Yeah, you're not losing anything if I leave. I'm heading in the same direction as you. For the moment.
Okay. Let's put it this way. If you decide to branch off at any point in time, just you then you would have to reroll and continue in our story.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm still following my character's motivations.
Yeah, okay.
No.
My character's motivations are money.
Man, okay. I hate greedy characters. Makes this game so boring.
Yeah.
Alright.
Okay.
I mean, I just came from the land of giants and stuff, which is basically where we're heading back to. I don't want to just head back to where I came from.
That's fair.
Are giants in the north?
Yeah,
there are giants in the mountains. They live in, there are some that live in the mountains.
Red, and, whatever. I can't remember what Dallas said. Red Wall?
Red Wall.
Which is between Norath and Ice Crown.
Okay.
Which is exactly where we're heading.
Okay, so,
during this time,
Ithania
has already left.
She said, fuck this, you guys are taking from the side, I'm out of here. Yeah, she just started walking down along the road and said, fuck it. You guys, I guess you guys run to catch up with her.
She just left while we were going.
I can't take all this bickering piss.
So, I mean, Harvick, do you still continue, or do you...
I'm going to continue on, because I think it's safest to stick with the group right now.
Okay. Sure, so, do you guys want to continue for 10 minutes, or...
Well, Josh said he might be able to go later than 10, it's up to Josh.
Okay.
I can go for as long as whatever, because I'm done.
I have to go, I have to be up early tomorrow.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so we're stopping now, or are you going for 10 minutes? Okay, at 10. Okay. So, yeah, it's like... I guess it's like 1 now, because you guys... Well, no, you guys went through town. I'll say that took... it's 2 o'clock now.
Going back really quick, did they mention to us about the child thing?
We explained everything.
We didn't bring up the child, because it didn't seem important.
Well, you guys just said differing things right there.
Whatever.
Wait, hang on. Did you bring... Would you ever... I wouldn't have brought up child.
What?
I guess it wasn't really important. I wouldn't
have... Like, if I was explaining what was happening, I wouldn't have brought up the child.
Yeah, me neither.
Okay.
Would you guys say anything happened if we asked if anything happened?
I'd probably say there was a child who came and looked at us and ran off to the farms.
I would think it would be mentioned, yeah.
Because that's literally the only thing that happened.
Oh. So nothing?
I suppose in that case, I mean, like...
I honestly wouldn't be concerned. I mean, it's a child.
Our names and like faces aren't being posted yet, so I don't think he would have recognized us. If anything, he ran off because you're butt ugly. I'm sorry, I don't actually say that. Probably ran off because I don't know. You guys were like 4 people in a ditch, 3 people.
Ditch. So yeah. Okay,
I mean, if you want, you could go look for the child.
I was just... I can't comment on things unless you tell us you saw a child. So
okay.
I can't really... Unless you say that, I can't comment on
anything. I don't think I'd say anything.
I would not say anything, because that really does not seem like it would entry.
It's not
important. I mean, the kid was hiding behind the old man the entire time, so... Well, he ran off after, I guess, but yeah.
I mean, like, in the... I mean, unless we saw that child, I don't think we would have cared enough about it. A small child that really say anything? I really don't think we would have said anything about the child.
Alright.
Although, one more thing I do need to bring up. Does anyone here have high intelligence or God, that's not it. Anybody here potentially well-versed in crafting potions?
Not at all.
Ask Ithania.
Ask Ithania?
Yes, actually I do. I do know how to craft a few potions.
I have a recipe here. Could you make this for me? I have the ingredients too.
Like, what it says here it'll take a day, but yeah, that's possible. If we stop somewhere for a day where I can let it sit.
Yeah, that's fine.
Were there any weaponsmiths in this town?
We didn't check.
There's a general store.
Are we planning on avoiding it now, or are we going to go back in?
It would look weird if me and Rayon went back in, but I suppose it'd be fine for you, because we don't know our faces.
Fuck it, whatever, we'll just wait till the next town.
Okay, so you guys, I guess you guys keep heading east, or do you guys...
There's a road leading north, I guess.
It's northeast or southeast, you can choose one or the other.
Where's the road split?
In the middle, either northeast or southeast.
Yeah, so after the village, the road splits?
Yeah.
Is what you're saying?
Yeah.
What's both northeast? North. Do we know?
Yeah. Is there a sign?
No.
There's no road signs?
Nope.
And I'm assuming that you guys didn't ask anything while you were in the village.
We didn't ask too much. We wanted to leave in case.
No one bought a map.
Fuck. Yeah, that's what we should have bought. God damn it. I forgot about that.
I'm gonna go into the village. Would anybody like to come with me quickly?
I will. I need to buy arrows.
Yes, please. Okay. I'm gonna go find an armory and a general store.
I guess me and Rand will stay outside this time.
Won't take too long.
I'll go.
How much time we have?
Okay. I'm gonna go to the armory first. I don't know who's if we're all stick traveling together or what we're doing.
I'll go with you. They probably sell.
I guess I'll go with arrows at the armory.
Armory's all I'm interested in.
Do the guards even say anything as they enter?
They'll say the same thing. So they say, "Hold, state your business."
We're passing mercenaries, just passing through town.
All sorts, huh? Don't cause any troubles. Only fights going off in this city, in this town.
All right, sir. No problem.
Don't they ask for names?
Yeah. What are your names?
I'll be good.
John.
Harry.
John.
Jeremiah.
Where?
What?
From where?
Oh, from where? I'm originally from up in Ice Crown, but I've been traveling for a while as a sellsword.
Okay. And dwarf?
Once again, I've been traveling for quite some time, but I'm originally from Hive City.
No, that's it's a Hive City. That's not the city place name. The faction name is Moradin, or Durin, or Kazaroth. Okay. That's okay. And you, sir? Any points to Aldir?
Neverwinter, but I've been traveling with these guys for a long time now.
Oh, wow. Cross the sea. Aren't you excited? Yeah.
That's right.
Just how I like him.
Just how I like him, child. Yeah, he lets you in.
Okay, I go to the blacksmith.
Okay. He says, hello there.
Hi.
What do you need?
Hi.
Hi. What kind of steel do you need?
I'm gonna sell him the scale armor and the bastard sword I have.
You had the? Oh. Yeah. You had one set, right?
Yeah, that's why I wanted to know if it was a blacksmith.
God damn it.
The bastard sword is a nice looking one, right?
Decent, yeah.
Okay. He looks at it and then looks at the pommel and says, "Where did you get this?"
Picked it up off some dead highwaymen.
Off some highwaymen, huh? Well, you're gonna go have to hand that in to the guard. I'm not taking that.
Okay.
What's wrong with it?
Yeah.
What's up? It's to Sir Gilmore's house. He's gonna want that back. I'm not taking it.
Well. Okay. Can I sell him the scale armor?
Yeah, the scale armor, he'll take it off your hands for 22.
22 gold?
Yep.
Cool. What does he have for sale? What are his specialty wares?
He's just a average blacksmith, so stuff you'll find in the player's handbook.
Okay, so he doesn't have anything okay, sure, whatever.
No.
Alright, I'm good.
But he says, I do however, and he pulls out this ingot of metal, this mithril, and he plants it on the table.
So it's just one ingot?
It's one ingot of mithril. This here can craft you a fine weapon. I'm willing to sell this to you for 1,000.
What can you make with one ingot, though?
One weapon.
So one shove any weapon?
And it's a hammer.
Yep.
Can I make armor out of it too, or is it only good for a weapon?
It's not enough. It's not enough.
So I can make like a great axe with it.
Yep.
Yeah, how much better would a mithril weapon be than a common weapon?
Really mithril is really good. It's basically in Game of Thrones equivalent of Valyrian steel. But the problem is here though.
I have to find a blacksmith who can work it. Yeah.
Where did you get this?
Yeah, where did you get this?
well, it's, I got off a friend.
Yeah?
I'll buy it.
Yeah.
Whoa, I'm talking to the blacksmith right now, Aladir. You can wait your turn in line,
buddy. I need
to
buy arrows.
I'm talking to him right now. You wait in line. Okay. Right. So you just a friend had it? Did this friend possibly know where a blacksmith would be who could work this fine piece of metal?
No idea. The friend left town as quickly as possible.
Was this friend a black market dealer, perhaps?
Well, I don't know about that, but he was just quick to leave town.
So this isn't any sort of illegal stolen mithril that I'm possibly buying?
I don't know where it came from.
This isn't something the guards might want to know about?
Not that I know of.
No?
Not that I know of.
Okay. So, if it was found out that you had this or something, this wouldn't be, like, horrible for you?
Probably not.
Can I roll an intimidation?
Sure. What do you say?
What I just said, basically.
Sure, yeah.
I'm trying to coerce him into lowering the price for me.
Oh, God.
Okay.
It's not illegal. Why would he be scared?
Because he just said he got it from a friend who ran off.
So?
I don't know. It sounds suspicious to
Maybe
me.
Maybe he just has social anxiety.
Even if the other guy stole it, he acquired it legally.
Well, I mean, I guess you try and say that when a stern voice says, "Hey, man, I don't know where it's from. Not my problem. The guards want to confiscate it. They could, I guess, but, you know, that'd just be shitty."
So you could only possibly make one weapon out of this?
As far as I know, I'm no mithril smith myself, but I mean, if you found someone who's good enough.
No, I know. I'm more asking, I guess, in general. There's no, like, way to make two small weapons out of it?
Maybe, and he kind of like holds up and he's like, it's like the same, and he pulls up like an iron ingot and he says, yeah, it's about the same size, maybe. I mean, I've never worked mithril myself, but you know, he plants it back on the table.
Fuck it, I'll buy it.
1,000 gold, alright.
There we go.
Just out of curiosity, how much gold do you have left?
1,190.
You're rich, bro.
The fuck? What did I spend all my gold on?
I might have just been hoarding some gold sometimes.
I don't think you've been taking any of the loot. So.
Out of character, I'm gonna say that when we opened up that chest, this is not on record, okay? I'm just telling you guys out of character. When we opened up that chest in the cave and it had all the gold, I took it all because you guys forgot about it.
Okay. Yeah, he did.
I don't remember what cave we're talking about now.
When you got the acid shot in your eyes or poison.
Oh, goddammit. Okay.
Yeah, you wouldn't have known.
He didn't see inside. He's just gas in your face, basically.
Okay, I'm done in the blacksmith. I'll wait for the other two to finish their business.
Okay, Alier, what do you do?
I need to buy arrows. I don't know if he would sell them.
Oh, yeah, I got a few from the Fletcher yesterday.
Excellent. I need 14.
14. There's... I don't know. You'll have to look in the player's handbook for that, but whatever that is.
Alright, I don't even know what that's under.
Neither do I. Yeah, let's
weapons?
Just find that.
Ammunition.
Ammunition.
Buy a boat for 10k.
I guess I'll just buy 30, because it's 1 gold for 30.
Sure. Okay.
So, is it reasonable to carry, like, close to 60 arrows?
I mean, I guess you have some in your pack, but, yeah, I mean, I guess after you go through 30 of them, I would say you'd have to spend a turn to, like, or spend a minor action to, like, load them more into your quiver.
You could have two quivers.
Yeah,
oh, man.
That's possible.
What a badass.
I've seen people, like, you wear one quiver on each side of your hip.
Yeah, but, I mean, I'm not gonna let you do that in combat without being encumbered, so... You know, you'd have to actually take a minor action after like 30 arrows, I guess.
Yeah.
But I don't know in what battle you're going to shoot 30 arrows.
Yeah, I don't
so.
Think that's going to happen.
So, yeah.
One where he misses a lot.
Just twin shot, miss 15 times. Just fuck everything up. Okay, Harpek, are you doing anything?
Do you have hammers?
What kind of hammers?
I'm going to plop my big old hammer on the table and say that kind.
I mean, that's just a standard one, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's he stuff. Pulls up another one that looks exactly the same. He's like, right here. Want another one?
We'll trade you.
Alright. He takes your hammer and he takes.
I mean, yeah, hey, probably got a deal. Yeah. It's a fucking stupid blacksmith.
Okay, we're set. I got myself a trusty new hammer.
So it's exactly the same stats.
Yeah.
When we leave.
Shinier, though.
When we leave the.
It looks polished.
Okay. We go to the general store, okay? Wherever maps are sold. I'm assuming there's not a map specialty store. It would just be the general store.
No, it wouldn't be a general store map. Well, no, maps wouldn't be in a general store. I don't think you'd actually have to go to a cartographer for that.
Seriously?
Yep.
Is there a cartographer here?
There is, actually.
Wow. It's convenient.
I guess would be with the mayor of the town. So do you go to the mayor's office?
Yeah.
Okay. So yeah, the guards.
The cartographer's with the mayor?
Yeah. It's a town. It's not a city where a cartographer would have like its own business.
If the mayor needs maps drawn up?
Yeah.
So they don't have like pre-drawn versions of these maps then?
They do, but they would be with the mayor, basically. Because, I mean, he would be the only one who would need a map around here. If this were, like, a city, then, yeah, he'd probably be, you know, his own shop or something like
that. How long have we actually been traveling for, like, prior to the actual start of this campaign? That we didn't have a fucking map.
Depends on your character.
20-something days?
Well, the thing is, Aelim had a map, and then you guys were in the city. So, yeah.
I can't believe we never had a map. That doesn't come in, like, the standard adventurer kit.
Nope.
No, man. If this is medieval times,
maps are kind of
crazy
rare.
Only noble people, like nobles, would learn how to draw maps.
Not to mention half the population is illiterate, so you got that too.
Okay, well, I guess we go in here then.
Okay, yeah. So the guards say, "Halt, what's your business?"
We are looking for the cartographer to purchase a map of the land.
Oh, okay.
Lands.
Yeah. What are your names? And I guess you guys give the.
Harry.
John.
Jeremiah.
Okay. And then you give the places you're from. Yep. And he says, okay, yeah, head on in. His office is down that way.
Okay.
So, yeah. You guys arrive outside the office.
Yep.
And you guys, I guess, knock on the door and he says, yeah, come in.
Hello, good sir. We are interested in purchasing a map of the lands. I guess it would be Aboricum.
Of all of Aboricum?
I mean, if we're going to be going into like Norath and Icecrown soon, I feel like a map of just Aurelia is kind of useless, isn't it?
Oh, okay.
Or fine, I guess maps of Aurelia, Norath, and
Icecrown.
Three maps, huh? Okay. He like shuffles through a bunch of paper and he says, "I got a map of Aurelia and Aboricum."
So he has a map of the whole world and he has a map of Aurelia and that's it?
Yep.
Do you have the knowledge to draw other maps?
I could. It would take a few days, but that's possible.
Yeah. How much for the map of Aurelia?
The map of Aurelia, I'll sell that to you for 75, and the map of Aboricum for 150.
Guys, do we really need the map of Aboricum?
I mean, how detailed is it? Does it have roads and stuff?
Probably. It has all the main roads, so all the merchant roads. Okay.
Well, that'd probably be a good idea, then.
How are we going to split this up? That's like 225, then. We want to split that five ways?
I can buy the big map.
You want that?
Yeah, I'll buy it.
Okay. For leaving Aurelia, I just spent a bunch of money on stuff. I'll split the map for Aurelia with people. I don't really have a use for it singly.
Just putting this out there, but I already told you guys that I bought food for everyone, so...
Alright.
Harvick!
I have very much money.
I think he's broke.
Yeah, he's the one who got the least amount.
He got like no reward.
Yeah, I could get no reward.
All right, about the map of Boricum.
You know what? Do we even need the map of Aurelia?
Probably not, actually.
I see why we would.
How close are we to the border of Norath?
The border? Let's see here. Estimate that. I don't have a map myself drawn yet, so I guess it would take. I guess that would take you. I said 3 months to Norath, so I guess that would take you a month to get to Norath. Yeah. the place you want. Yeah.
Fuck it, I'll buy the map. It's my fucking map, though.
Alright.
Take my 75 gold.
Alright. I gotta go.